the opening of the first Bitcoin futures market. That's going to begin Sunday night. Let's talk to the man in charge of all this. Ed Tilley is the CEO of the CBOE. And Ed, congratulations. You've won this sort of arms race to get to the first Bitcoin futures. CME will be doing it a week later. But I'm wondering what your take is on Bitcoin. What do you think trading Bitcoin futures will do for Bitcoin? Will it make it more respectable? Will the shorts come in and try to blow up the price? Will it lower the volatility? What do you think is going to happen?
Well, thanks, Bob. Thanks for having me here. It's really a pleasure. Yeah, we're looking forward to the launch Sunday afternoon. This has been about 6 months of getting ready for the launch. A lot of preparation with our regulator, the CFTC. So what we expect first day and any new product, this won't be different. Actually, a very slow ramp up. I think we'll be building liquidity in the coming days and weeks and months. So a lot to learn after that opening bell Sunday afternoon. As for volatility, I think any time that buyers and sellers are able to express their interest in a lit, transparent market, one with regulation and oversight, sure, I think that might have a dampening effect on the volatility we've seen over the last couple days in Bitcoin.
But I'm just curious about what you think this will do for Bitcoin. Do you think it will make it more legitimate? You're familiar with Jamie Dimon's famous comment. Mr. Dimon had said, if you're stupid enough to buy Bitcoin, you're going to pay the price for it one day. He called it a fraud. Do you think this is an opportunity for Bitcoin? Do you think this is another great investment, or is it a fraud? What's your take on this?
Yeah, I think like with any investment vehicle, any way to express an interest in a commodity, the ability to do so, whether it's Jamie Dimon's, as you point out, expressing the short interest of the short side. We have those, obviously, that are investing in Bitcoin each and every day. And I think where the meeting of those minds on a lit and transparent exchange is really what we're trying to bring to the marketplace. Legitimizing, I don't know. There's a suitability issue with every investment. Bitcoin should be no different. I don't think we're setting up Bitcoin and saying that's for everybody, but we certainly know there's interest out there on the long and the short side.
What do you say to Jamie Dimon's of the world who insists that this is a fraud? People like coming on saying that. What do you say to that? And I know you're a market guy, you provide a marketplace, but do you give us an opinion on this? You're in the middle of this.
I think as everyone in any investment, I think you can have an opinion on any security, any commodity. If Jamie Dimon would like to take the other sides of our longs, I think that's great. We'll provide a marketplace for him to do so.
Got to let you go, but just 10-second answer. ETF for Bitcoin. I know you got turned down this year. You and the Winklevoss twins, you're going to reapply. And do you think the SEC will approve it this time?
I think over time, the SEC will get comfortable. Remember, their mandate and their charter is customer protection. So I think we've got a long road ahead of us, making sure that the SEC is comfortable with our oversight, our information sharing with Gemini. And when we get prepared to launch an ETN or ETF, it'll be after months and months of dialogue with the SEC.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.